We have never been closer to the space company's long-awaited first test launch into space. It's also the best ever look we've had at SpaceX's vision for the future of space exploration and space-based, long-haul transportation. To build a fully reusable launch system for its interplanetary Starship vehicle, SpaceX has had to solve many technical challenges. As slowing the massive spacecraft down, as it re-enters Earth's atmosphere near orbital velocities. But perhaps the biggest challenge is always with rockets, is fairly mundane its mass. The goal with a rocket is to build the lightest possible vehicle, with the greatest amount of performance. In theory it sounds simple, but in practice containing volatile liquids at high pressures, is anything but simple and with a fully reusable launch system. SpaceX has the added challenge of building vehicles, that can withstand the rigor of launch perform in a vacuum, and then return screaming through the atmosphere to land back at sea level pressures. The need to build light, strong and adaptable vehicles, sometimes leads to interesting design choices, and SpaceX Orbital launch mount another reason is that, super heavy booster does not have legs to land on concrete. As usual its purpose is to reduce the overall weight, making it possible to carry more cargo and fuel to orbit, and to Mars. So the design team came up with the idea of building a catch tower, and also build orbital launch mount, to place super heavy booster and support. Something I haven't seen discussed, are their plans for a deluge system at the Boca Chica Starship launch site. The launch ring is pretty high up, so I doubt vibration dampening is necessary. However, a deluge system also helps with sound dampening, which seems important to mitigate environmental impact, and maintain friendly relations with the locals. During a launch, the exhaust plume would surround the launch pad and surrounding areas. The plume would extend radially from the pad, approximately 0.6 mile until reaching ambient temperature. SpaceX is still determining whether a diverter would be used under the launch mount. A diverter is a metal structure placed on the launch pad underneath the rocket, to divert the rocket plume laterally away from the ground. SpaceX is also still considering whether deluge water would discharge on the plume during a launch or test. If water were used, most of the water would be vaporized. If treatment or retention of stormwater or wastewater is required, SpaceX would retain the water in retention ponds adjacent to the launch mount. SpaceX would determine the exact number, location, and size of the retention ponds, within the VLA based on quantities of deluge water and final site plans. SpaceX would develop appropriate sampling protocols, and water quality criteria in coordination with the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality. SpaceX would remove water-containing contaminants, that exceed the water quality criteria, and haul it to an approved industrial wastewater treatment facility nearby. SpaceX would pump all other water not containing prohibited chemicals, back to the water storage tanks at the launch site. If surface water discharge were required, SpaceX would apply for a Texas Pollutant Discharge Elimination System permit, prior to the discharge event. All water, including deluge and potable water, would be either delivered by truck, or withdrawn from existing or new wells located adjacent to the launch pad. The launch tower, the launch table is another important construction project, that is being worked on day and night, in order to be ready for operation, at the end of this month and beginning of October. The orbital launch mount consists of two main components, six columns and one orbital launch table hexagonal symmetry. All the way down to the mount's foundation piling suggests that, SpaceX's new Starship pad design, will begin with the bare minimum needed for a sturdy launch pad. SpaceX may change the design for Super Heavy, but Starship's thrust section is attached to a skirt, with six strengthened sections, that host landing legs and hold down clamps. Starship orbital launch mount, capable of surviving the fury of Starship's Super Heavy booster, and the upper part of the foot poles, is being assembled by talented SpaceX engineers. In a different area predicting both parts will be about 20 meters tall, and according to my opinion, is about 12 to 15 meters. How does the structure and design work in an operation of each part of orbital launch mount? The six columns of the ULM have been filled with concrete, and built into a solid hexagon, next to the capture tower. The Starship launch mount are unlike any other rocket launchers. In Starship launch mount there are clamps, which will make by stainless steel and be designed to be very flexible activated by a remote control system. It will help to fix the Super Heavy booster, when it is placed on the launch pad, at the same time it is also very flexible while unfolding during Starship launch. One of the special designed points of orbital launch mount or cutouts, in the launch table for sound suppression water system, it will create a massive flow rate of 300,000 gallons water per minute. Super Heavy will be as tall as the entirety of a Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy rocket, first stage, second stage, and payload fairing included. Powered by up to 31 Raptor engines, the Super Heavy booster will produce upwards of 72,000 kilonewtons of thrust at liftoff, 9 times the thrust of Falcon 9, triple the thrust of Falcon Heavy, and double the thrust of Saturn V, the most powerful liquid fuel rocket ever to reach orbit. Combined with Starship, the full stack will weigh roughly 5,000 metric tons, 11 million pounds, fully fueled. Another effect that SpaceX may be aiming for here is to cool down the Raptor engines after a long flight. But there is an environmental problem, that is when water pour in and evaporate under the enormous heat of the engine exhaust, this makes up most of the huge exhaust plume to do this water system. SpaceX must definitely install pipes and high-pressure pumping elements, and launch table. But how exactly Elon Musk's engineers designed and installed it, we still wait a few weeks until Starship launched to orbit and how does booster catching system could work or this catching system is working or not. With orbital launch mount, so have you ever wondered how these two new designs work together? During an orbital launch attempt, a reusable Super Heavy first stage booster will detach from the Starship, and come back to Earth for a vertical landing. Eventually SpaceX wants to use catcher arms on the launch tower to capture the descending first stage. After catching the Super Heavy booster, the four fins attached to its body will be released, to prevent the first stage from falling at the same time. It will rotate a distance, so that it can accurately place the Super Heavy in the correct position of the orbital launch mount. At this point the clamps on the launch table adjust, to fix the first stage, then the capture tower will release the booster's body, and rotate back to its original position, and the fins will also fold down. The Starship will then be installed and continue for the next launch, at the orbital launch mount. To put designs like this into practice, it would require years of refinement and experimentation, be rapidly inspected, refueled and launched again. Whether this all works out remains to be seen. SpaceX has tried many things in the past in regard to rockets only to discard these ideas. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get that, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.